The identity of the Lady of the Dunes was solved by the relatively new technique of genetic genealogy, using DNA and family trees to zero in on the person of interest, be it victim or perpetrator. The same approach used to crack the Golden State Killer case in California. But no one discounts the decades of investigative work that came before.
Strikeout.
Let's not forget the work that the Provincetown police have done over the years on this case. They never abandoned this case.
No one worked the case harder than James Meads, now deceased.
The murder and the search for the victim's identity has continued to disturb the sleep of Provincetown Police Chief James Meads.
In this Ron Golubin news piece, 9 years into the case, Chief Meads was still hard at it. He'd been in touch with authorities all over the country and traveled to Canada in search of answers, haunted by questions.
As time grows on, my hopes diminish.
Even after he retired, he would still reach out to his successors, try to help out in any way he could, give them any information. He just never let it go until the day he died, basically.
When news broke that Ruth Terry's 48 years as a nameless corpse had finally come to a merciful end, Jimmy Meads Jr. came straight down to tell his father in St. Peter Cemetery.
We did it. Yep, knelt down, knocked on his gravestone, and told him we did it.
Just a stone's throw away, Jimmy and a current police detective placed a temporary marker on Ruth's grave, at long last, granting her the dignity of a name.
It was emotional. A few tears, some hugging and stuff. A lot of people put a lot of work and effort into it and kind of hovered over everyone for a long time. And finally, it's come to an end, at least. Now we know.
Many of us who are working the case today were in grade school when this horrific crime happened.
The mystery of the Lady of the Dunes was a haunting inheritance for generations of investigators. Over the years, there were many theories. Local serial killer Tony Costa was floated as a suspect, as was a young Bay State felon who broke out of prison and disappeared around the time of the body's discovery. There was speculation that the unidentified woman in the dunes had been a walk-on in the film Jaws, shot earlier that summer in Martha's Vineyard. And the missing hands and removal of teeth reminded others of the work of one James Whitey Bulger.
It very much mimicked what Whitey would do, trying to get rid of any clues, any, you know, the hands, the fingerprints.
In 2012, Sandra Lee wrote The Shanty, a lightly fictionalized account of the murder.
You see, Lee says she was actually there in Provincetown that summer, camping near the murder site with her siblings and stepfather when she was a young girl.
Lee claims to have actually seen the body, and in a 2015 interview with Chronicle, wondered if her stepfather and Whitey had something to do with it.
My stepfather at the time when the body was found was an associate of his, and we were down there at the time. I instantly felt in my heart and in my gut that my stepfather had something to do with it.
This is like a mystery that I've sort of carried around for nearly half a century, most of my life.
Today, Sandra Lee is still processing the news that Ruth Marie Terry has been identified.
I was stunned when I received the news that we know Ruth's name now. I was thrilled, but I had to sort of keep making sure that I wasn't dreaming.
Lee has made the pilgrimage out to Provincetown at least once a year to visit the anonymous grave in the old cemetery there. This year's trip will be decidedly less solemn.
I can't wait to get down to her grave in Provincetown myself and just, I don't know what'll happen. I'll probably cry and I'll just probably say, Ruth, we know who you are. It happened.
And we've been told that Ruth Marie Terry may be exhumed one last time to bring her home to the family burial plot in Tennessee. That decision will be up to her son, who lives in Michigan. Chronicle reached out to let him know we were working on this story, but we did not hear back.